If you remember from the last video, I spray painted a bunch of clear acrylic to make rulers. Well, I have some of that left over, so I thought I would test out some different methods for finishing keychains. I grabbed these awesome SVGs off of Creative Fabrica, which I will show you, and thank you so much to them for sponsoring this video. And I'm gonna show you these different ways that you can finish the keychains. I absolutely love all of these methods for different reasons and for different applications, and so I wanna make sure that you know how to do all of them. These five finishing techniques will really up the professionalism of your keychains so that you can feel confident to sell them and have your customers absolutely love them. We're gonna do UV resin with added glitter, a 16th inch backer, Crystallac Grand Finale, and a combination of Crystallac glitter glue to add some glitter with Grand Finale on top of that. Now, you may choose some of these methods based on your time, based on the cost. UV resin is quite expensive when you need to use a lot of it, but it is very fast. Crystallac is wonderful, water-based, non-toxic, but it takes you multiple days to be able to finish a keychain. So we'll talk about all of those different things as I go through each of these methods. Here on this channel, I'm focused on easy projects to help you gain confidence in using your laser. Remember, you can laser, you just need the confidence to get started. If you're new here, I want to make sure that you head down to the description and head over to our Facebook group where we talk about all of these things in real time and we help you work on those things that you need to build your laser business. So I made a whole bunch of these keychains using the spray painted clear acrylic that I had left over from my ruler video. Let me show you what that looks like before it's cut. So these are the two that I had left. I had kind of this blue and purple, and you can see on the back, I actually spray painted some white to just kind of make more of an ombre effect. And then I realized you can't actually see that through. So that's where I learned how to spray paint effectively. The other color that I had is this pink ombre combination, which I really loved for those kind of sunset vibes. I love a surfer aesthetic, and so these were really just right up my alley. So I went on Creative Fabrica to go find some surf-inspired SVGs. I was really feeling those surf vibes, and I wanted some surf-related keychains, and I found this awesome SVG set. When I looked at it, I was a little bit concerned because someone hand-painted all of these keychains, and that is not in my wheelhouse at all. I wanted to do something that was more my aesthetic and the way that I'm able to create. I took those spray painted sheets of acrylic and just ran with it. I wanted to see how the engravings turned out, and they turned out awesome. But then I was looking at them and I thought we could get a little bit more out of them with some added finishing touches. And that's what I'm gonna show you today. You could absolutely leave these alone and just spray with some sort of clear sealant, but I wanted them to have a smooth back so that they really feel professional and sturdy. Let's get into that first method, which is using UV resin. If you're just using UV resin, you need UV resin. I like this one from Counterculture DIY because it isn't sticky. So it tends to move really easily and it cures really nicely. So I really enjoy this one. The next thing that you're gonna need is the curing lamp. So I also have this one I got in a set from Counterculture DIY. This will be linked in my description below. I like the size of it and the number of lights, and that I can really get a lot under it when I want to cure. This is just on a USB plug, so super easy to use. It has a 30 second and a 60 second setting. You likely will have to set that multiple times. You also can cure UV resin just in your window, which I tend to do after I have done my first UV resin project. And then you're gonna need your keychain. In this case, I really, really liked this pink one the way it was. I felt like the engravings really showed up and it didn't really need anything else. So I just wanna keep it the way it is. So I quickly cleaned out the engraving to make sure that there was no remaining dust. And then I'm going to go ahead and set that UV resin. This is a pretty simple process. I'm gonna put on my nitrile gloves before I do this, just to make sure that I don't get anything in the resin, but also that if I need to touch anything, it's not on my fingers. And then I'm just gonna apply a little bit and see if I have enough. You don't need a ton, especially for something like this, And you may want to do a couple layers just to get it exactly right. So I'm just gonna spread that all around. And then I'm going to use my silicone tool to spread it to the edges. I'm on a silicone mat here so that it won't stick if anything were to fall off the sides. So I really wanna make sure that I get this all spread around all the way to the edges and try to get it sort of even and level. Now it's going through that keychain hole, so I need to make sure that I move that before I cure this. And you can also see that I'm getting quite a bit of bubbles. I'm gonna get those out in a second. Okay, so now I'm gonna pick up this keychain and just look at it and see how it's looking. It looks like I could use a little bit more around some of the edges, so I will work on that. That's easy, that one's done. And now we'll move on to our glitter UV resin. Okay, so next we're gonna mix up some glitter into our UV resin. I'm not actually sure how this color is gonna work, so we'll see how it goes. And if it doesn't work, we'll try a different color. I know that white would work, but I wanna try this blue with this blue that I have. So we'll see how it goes. The other things that I'm gonna need here are my glitter. I'm using this holographic, which I think is really fun. I'm gonna need my keychain. So this one is on a blue spray paint, and it doesn't have that really major contrast, which is why I wanted to try this. Again, I need my UV resin, same one, and I am just gonna pour some of that into my little cup here. And then I'm gonna use my shaker to get a little bit of the glitter. I don't wanna get too much glitter because then the UV resin doesn't have the light is what cures the UV resin. So if you get too thick, it can take a really long time to cure and it sort of defeats the purpose of the UV resin in the first place. So you wanna make sure you don't get too much glitter in any layer of your UV resin. So I can already tell I can add more glitter, but I wanna kinda see what it looks like on the other side. So yeah, you can see the glitter, but not a lot. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a little more UV resin and a little more glitter. All right, so now you can see that's getting a little bit more opaque. Okay, that's a cool effect, so I'm actually enjoying that. I may pop a little bit of white glitter in here at the end, we'll see. So again, just making sure that I spread that UV resin all the way to the edge. This one's a little easier to avoid the keychain hole because I can just have the UV resin cover the circular part. I don't actually need it to go up to that top part. I could if I wanted to, but I don't have to. One thing that's great about UV resin is because it is pretty thick, it's easy to move into where you want and have it stay. So once you sort of get it moving, it's easy to get it where you want it. All right, so I want to make sure that I get this glitter all the way out to the edges so I get a really consistent look all the way around. Okay, now I want to take a peek before I set this and just see if I like it. All right, I think that's pretty cool. It's like a nice little wave color, so I'm going to leave it how it is. And we are going to go ahead and pop that under the light. Oh, no, before we do that, we need to get the bubbles out. I can't really see the bubbles as much here in this glitter, but I just wanna run this across in case. And if I were to not like the look of this, I could always reset it and do one more layer. All right, that's it. Our UV resin keychains are done, so we can move on to our Crystalac grand finale and then our Crystalac with glitter glue and then grand finale. All right, so I've cleaned up the UV resin and the glitter from my mat, and now I'm gonna move on to the Crystalac products. We're gonna start with just a plain grand finale, super simple. You will need to do this over multiple days because the grand finale requires 2 hours of dry time between each coat, and you don't really wanna do more than 3 coats in a day. And then you'll want to sand in between every 3 coats. And that's just to make sure that you're getting a nice smooth finish. What I love about this is that it's a lot easier to execute it flawlessly than it is for me to do with UV resin. While UV resin gives me a quick finish, I still struggle to get it perfect. And so it may take me actually a little bit longer than this will just with the dry time. So if you're able to plan ahead, I really like this. It's non-toxic, and I'll show you, I can just do it with my fingers, which is awesome. I loved the way this one turned out. It doesn't need anything in my opinion. I think it's bright enough, and all I really wanna do is just go ahead and make sure that it's sealed. So I already cleaned it out and roughed it up a little bit with a tiny bit of sandpaper. And all I need for this one is my grand finale. You want thin coats of this. And this first coat is really just gonna sink right in. Now, if you didn't care about this being super smooth over time, you could just do a couple coats and be done with it. It would protect the paint, which is really the biggest thing I'm concerned about. But if you want to get a really smooth finish and not feel the engraving, then this is gonna need maybe somewhere between 6 and 9 coats. It could need more than that. It really just depends. But that's it. It's all smooth, it's one thin layer, and it's really important to do those thin layers so that it can cure properly. All right, so for this next one, I am gonna use a combination of Crystalac products. The first step in this process is to use glitter glue. So this is Crystalac glitter glue, and I need a brush. My brush is a little bit wet so that the glitter glue will spread more easily. It's just a nylon brush. And so I'm just gonna put a little bit of glitter glue on there, spread that out and see how it looks. And then I am going to sprinkle my glitter right onto that glitter glue. I'm using this piece of copy paper so that I can save my glitter when I'm done. Because as you can see, I didn't need that much glitter. So shook off my glitter. And that glitter glue is gonna need 4 hours. I can decide after that if I want to put another coat on, which I might. I didn't get some great coverage here on this edge, so I might put another coat on after that. All right, so those are our first 4 techniques. And the next one, we are gonna actually just cut a backer from 16th inch white acrylic. So I'm gonna show you how we do that now. The last method that I'm gonna show you is by far the easiest, but it just may not be the look that you're going for. So I am going to layer on a 1/16 inch piece of white acrylic using 3M tape. This is, like I said, really easy to do. You'll just cut the outside shape again from your keychain and make sure that you have the 3M on before you cut it and apply it. It's real, real simple. You are going to have your piece of acrylic that you've already painted and cut and engraved, and you're gonna have your piece of 3M backed white acrylic. I think this is easier to place the piece with the 3M tape down first and then place the other on top of it because then I can see the edges. So I'm gonna peel that backer and then I'm gonna take the other piece and I'm just gonna lay it down, line it up, make sure all my edges are aligned. Then I'm just gonna press it down and that is it. So now you have that nice finished backer. I think this one would be great if you wanted to personalize it. I actually think also larger and made as a luggage tag would be super cute. You could put the name on the front side over the engraving, or you could put it on the back side. You could engrave it and paint it. So there's a lot of options with this one. I think I'm gonna play around with that some more. What would you wanna see? Do you wanna see how you would engrave it after? Do you wanna see how you might layer on a name? I absolutely love the possibilities with that. I thought it might be helpful to see what I actually use to assemble the keychains. So I like to use these little plastic connectors. I get mine from Audrey Min from Min to Be Designs. And what I like about these is that you get this nice clean look on your keychain, but they're also great because of the flexibility. So you tend to not break your acrylic, which I appreciate. And then I like split rings instead of jump rings. Because I have those two ends, it just is more secure than a jump ring, which is so easy to bend. This one is a little bit smaller than I typically use. This is 6 millimeters and I prefer 8 millimeters, although the 6 millimeters looks really good. And then I just get a regular keychain hardware. So I like to attach the jump ring to this first. There are tools for this, but I just use my fingers. And then once that's on, then I just push this through the split ring, and it's much easier with that slightly larger split ring, but I bend it so you can see it's like halfway through there, and then just push that through. Like I said, much easier with a larger split ring, but that works fine, and then you just close it. So then you have that nice clean look there against that acrylic. Like I said, I really like the way that looks. And with this smaller one, it actually looks really nice. It's not so noticeable, but I prefer the ease of an 8 millimeter. So those are my 5 methods for finishing keychains. And I think that these just give your keychains a new level of professionalism and a reason to buy over someone else's. Let me know which one was your favorite. I have a personal favorite, but I'm not gonna share it until I see your comments come through. If you aren't using Creative Fabrica yet, what are you waiting for? The number of fonts alone that you have access to there is extraordinary. You can check out the one in this ruler video that I used recently that has alternate characters that are doodles. How awesome is that? Just little doodles to add to your projects. It's awesome. If you don't have a Creative Fabrica subscription yet, you can get a free trial by clicking the link in my description. And thanks again to them for sponsoring this video.